you know what it means to miss New Orleans, where mockingbirds used to sing. I'd like to see the lazy Mississippi a-hurrying in to spring. Oh, the Mardi Gras, the memories of Creole's tunes that fill the air. I dream of old Yanders in June, and soon I'm wishing that I was there. Do you know what it means to miss New Orleans, when that's where you left your heart? There's something more, I miss the one I care for more than I miss New Orleans.
Name was William Holmes Varden.
Apparently, Mr. Varden died evening before last from multiple injuries suffered when his pickup truck went off a bridge into a shallow canal. Anybody know him?
Oh, he and his wife Olive been coming in on and off for years.
Cool, I'll get it. You sit down.
The accident happened about an hour after he left here. It seems he was intoxicated at the time.
How many drinks did y'all give that man?
Thank you, Anna May. That was, in fact, going to be my first question. Tiger?
I don't recall, Bubba.
What you mean you don't recall?
The bar was real busy because of the rain. All of the construction men had the day off.
Well, do you remember serving Mr. Varden?
I'm not real sure. Maybe one or two.
Did Mr. Varden appear drunk to you?
No, I don't think so.
What you mean you don't think so? We could lose the whole restaurant over something like this, and you don't think so?
Anna May, hush up.
Well, now, that's not bad. One or two drinks, and the man didn't appear drunk. That's not bad at all. Yeah, Charles?
I was also waiting by Monday night. We both were, because of the crowd.
Uh-huh.
I believe I may have served Mr. Varden some drinks, too.
Oh, brother.
How many would you guess, Charles?
Maybe two, three.
Oh, brother.
But he wasn't drunk. At least he didn't look drunk to me.
Unfortunately, there are several witnesses who say otherwise. That was Mr. Varden's lawyer's office. The family has retained counsel and intends to sue.
Oh, brother.
Who's the lawyer?
Some woman by the name of Jan Rudy.
Oy vey.
You know her?
Heard of her.
Yeah?
She's kind of a jerk.
Jerk? Now, there's some good news.
Brilliant jerk, Frank.
I'm sorry I'm late. It's not a ploy, it's the traffic in this town, which is going to strangle us all before it's over. How you do, Mr. Parrish?
Not so good.
Yeah, so I hear.
Miss Rudy, this is Mr. Weisberger. He's Mr. Parrish's counsel.
Weisberger?
You probably know my uncle. He's with Skinner Davis.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he's your uncle? Well, he's a fine fella. Who are you with?
I'm with myself. I practice alone.
Yeah? Too late?
Law school. Duke undergraduate.
No kidding. Duke. Decided to go north to college, huh? Well, anyhow, looks like we got us a situation here, doesn't it? You fellas want to say anything?
Well, it's
pretty early on, and we don't exactly know what we're up against. And Frank, Mr. Parrish, is the new owner of the restaurant. He's hardly been there a month.
A month? Oh, boy. It's a tough business, Mr. Parrish, from what I've heard.
Yeah, I kind of get that impression.
I'm sorry to interrupt, Mr. Weinberg.
That's quite all right. Yeah, Frank and I have looked over the insurance, the coverage, and it seems we're a little short there.
Uh-huh.
We're covered solidly for slip and fall, that type of thing, but this is special. It's different.
Sure.
So, considering everything, max coverage is $100,000 all in.
$100,000?
Yeah.
$100,000. I have a list here that's really just preliminary stuff of witnesses who say William Varden got pretty drunk at your place. Now, you can take that with you if you want, Mr. Weinstein.
Weisberg.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm just hell with names. Mr. Parrish, there's a whole bunch of litigation, a body of precedents. Now, that's previous cases. About a saloon or a restaurant being responsible for their clientele after they leave the premises. Now, that's your property.
Mrs. Rudy, I'm well aware of the situation.
Oh, is that right?
I think I should say that Mr. Parrish is a graduate of Brown University and was a college professor before coming in.
Oh, I see. Excuse me. I'm sorry. Well, maybe I just better get on with this. So, here's the deal, fellas. William Varden has a wife. Her name is Olive Varden. Now, I know this because Olive Varden has worked for my family off and on some 45 years. She worked for my mom and dad. She's worked for me. I spit up on her. My mother died in her arms. I've never known anyone so fine, so decent, or so honest in my entire life. Now, I don't usually screw around with things like this, but this is a mite personal to me, so as far as I'm concerned, this is the case in this office at this time. I intend to get for Mrs. Olive Varden the insurance money, the property, which I understand is freehold, the jukebox, the salt and pepper shakers, and any other little old things she may have coming to her. In short, gentlemen, I am your worst nightmare come true. Any questions so far?
Here's my question. Why would five people in a bar think the man was loaded and Cool and Tiger didn't? Now that's what I'd like to know.
I guess we were too busy to notice.
That's right.
Yeah, fellas, look at this list of names. You know any of these folks?
Yeah, I know that one. I know that one.
You know one thing we got going for us? Two bartenders. How is one man supposed to know what the other man is pouring?
No help, Frank doesn't mean a thing.
It doesn't, why not?
You're supposed to keep a tab. All you have to do is look at it to see what the customer's had overall.
Do we run a tab? What am I saying? Of course we don't run a tab.
We keep it in our heads.
Right.
Don't get too down, okay, Frank?
Down? My father ran this restaurant for 35 uninterrupted years. I'm here 5 weeks and I lose the whole thing. Tell you one thing, Bubba, I just hope you're one hell of a lawyer. That's all I can say.
I'm not going to be handling this case.
You're not? Why not?
Rudy's going to sue your insurance company. Their lawyer will handle it.
Oh, no. I want you.
Believe me, Frank, it's really the best thing. I do wills and deeds. You call me when the electrician overcharges you. Jan Rudy's major league, primo bosso. The insurance company will get a gunslinger to handle somebody like that.
Well, what are we supposed to do in the meantime? Just wait for this guy?
That's about it.
That's about...
You want a drink, Bubba?
No. No, thank you. Mr. Mellon? Cy Weisberger.
How you doing?
You got anything for me?
Sure do. William Varden.
Right.
Cerebral lacerations, bilateral hemithraces, multiple rib fracture, basilar skull fracture, big one, asphyxia due to drowning, and multiple small animal bites. Every fish, I reckon.
What about his blood alcohol content?
Way up there. Not a record, but pretty impressive, even by Nolan standards.
Well, how many drinks would you say he had?
10, 11, somewhere in there.
10 or 11?
I'm guessing, but that's what it looks like to me.
Thanks.
You bet.
Metastatic carcinoma, what's that?
That'd be your basic lung cancer.
Lung cancer?
Uh-huh.
Bad?
Bad. You ever hear good lung cancer?
Yeah, right. Well, thanks for your help.
That's what we're here for, my friend. Yes, hello? I'm still here.
What are those names?
The names are William and or Olive Varden.
Varden?
Uh-huh.
No.
And neither was ever a...
Hello? Hello? Are you still there, sir? Is anybody there? Hello?
And neither was ever a patient at your clinic?
No, I'm afraid not.
Uh-huh.
Neither one. Sorry.
Well, thank you. Bye-bye.
Both Olive and William started seeing me about 4 years ago. I couldn't get him off the cigarettes. Anyhow, about 3 months ago, he got sick. So I finally talked him into a physical, and we got some pretty bad pictures. X-rays. I sent him to a specialist, but, you know. Last time I saw him, he just thanked me, put on his hat, and went out the door. I never said a word.
So William Varden knew he was going to die?
Well, sure, of course.
Do you think he committed suicide?
No. No, I certainly do not.
Why is that funny?
Black people don't kill themselves, Mr. Weisberger. That's a white man's game.
Olive Varden live here? I'm an attorney at law. This has something to do with Mr. Varden's recent passing. I'd like to see Mrs. Varden.
We got a lawyer. You talk to her.
I already spoke with her. If I could just come in for a second.
Who you represent?
The restaurant.
The restaurant?
Yes, sir. That's correct. If I could come in for a second, use your telephone.
Find your own telephone, Jim. We ain't talking to you or nobody else.
If I could just come in for a second, 1 second.
Who's out there?
Nobody.
Well, I'm a little embarrassed about this. Bubba knew about this meeting. The secretary said he had gone to see the dead man's wife.
His wife? I'm not sure that's a real bright idea.
Well, I am. Big Arthur, do you know where the Arnold Graham projects are?
Yeah. Why?
Bubba's down there.
Bubba's down there?
Uh-huh.
Alone?
Yeah, I guess so.
Let's go.
Well, I'm here with the lawyer from the...
Let's go.
Let the man use the phone.
I don't want the man here. You understand? I told the man that.
up.
See what he's saying.
Oh, shut up, Clara.
Oh, he's crazy. He's just crazy, that's all.
I ain't crazy. You crazy.
Excuse me. Let me just say something, okay? Okay? I'm trying.
Well, you're not going to see my mother, so you can forget about that right now, Jack.
Well, see.
Well,
let the man talk, Jacob.
Go ahead. Don't matter to me. Let the man talk.
You all know Ennis Parrish, who owned the sheds.
Sure.
He's dead.
That's right. He's dead. So is my father.
Okay. Okay. And you all know the folks who work there at the sheds.
That's right.
Well, those are the folks I'm representing here today.
That's right. They're in big trouble. You tell them that.
That's right. They're in big trouble.
That's right.
Shut up, Lonnie.
Now, these people, they're from the community. They've been there for years and years. Am I right?
We used to go in there when we was little child.
That's right. And other places would come and other places would go, but the sheds was always there. And somebody get married and the sheds would bring the food. Somebody get buried, same thing. Sometimes folks couldn't pay, and Ennis would say, that's all right. See me when you can.
That's right.
When all the trouble started with the civil rights and people needed a place to meet, the sheds was always open. Two times crackers tried to firebomb that place.
That's right. I remember that.
But Ennis Parrish kept having those meetings. Anything for the community. Anytime people needed things, the sheds was as good or better than any church. And you all know that to be true.
My father's dead, that's what I know, because the chair sold him too much whiskey. Now you tell us something about that.
What's your name?
Mama, go back to bed. We're handling this.
Mrs. Barton, my name is Cy Weisberger, ma'am.
Sounds Jewish.
Yes, ma'am, it is.
Mama, don't be talking to this man. You don't have to say nothing to him, nothing at all.
Won't you come here?
Yes, ma'am.
William didn't like to eat out much because of the prices. But every time we went to the shade, they treated us like ladies and gentlemen.
Yes, ma'am.
Is Marie Walker still there?
Miss Marie? Oh, yeah.
I would be embarrassed because William would only tip a dime. He said that's what his father would give them. But his father was raised up before the turn of the century, Mark. I was ashamed. But Marie Walker, she never made a face or nothing. And every time we went back, she treated us like William give her a dollar or two. She always treated us like ladies and gentlemen.
It's Miss Marie.
Y'all got lots of insurance.
No, ma'am, we don't. That's the problem.
I think William thought y'all did.
He did.
Uh-huh.
And William knew he was sick, didn't he, Mrs. Varden?
But you must understand, William was an odd jobs yard man all his life.
Yes, ma'am.
He liked not having a boss. And when he got the cancer, we didn't have any Social Security or insurance or hardly nothing at all.
And he was worried about how you'd get along without him. I went to the bridge. It looked like he drove on off.
When he promised me that he wouldn't do it, That's when I knew he would. That's when I knew.
So we had a few drinks at the Chaz and then went out and had some more.
And pretended to be drunk without the bomb in sight. He planned it all out in the kitchen. He even wrote himself
little notes.
Is there anything else?
No, ma'am.
Then I believe I can sleep now.
Thank you, ma'am.
He should have gone to a big hotel downtown and done it. One of them chains.
Yes, ma'am.
Don't you ever come down here alone again?
No, I won't.
He ain't going to court, Frank.
I'm not? How come?
Because at the Chaz, everybody gets treated like ladies and gentlemen.
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, that's quite a story. Quite a story indeed. I really appreciate you coming down here in person. It's mighty nice of you.
They've taken up a collection at the restaurant for Mrs. Varden, so...
Don't you worry about that. My husband and I'll take care of Olive. She won't have anything to want for. I guarantee you that.
Bye-bye.
Do you ever think about joining a big law firm? Maybe someday becoming a partner?
Well, to tell you the truth, I'm kind of fond of working alone. Guess it's just me.
Uh-huh.
Well, see you in court.
Mr. Weisberger, I sincerely hope not.
Next time on Frank's Place.
It's a good idea, Mr. Holloway.
He's my uncle.
It's still a good idea.
We got a meeting tonight.
I know it.
Complaint?
Probably.
If I didn't care.
The capital C.
Capital C?
You don't have to check with anybody, do you?
I'm gonna kill the man who took it.
Good.
Tiger, they must be killed.
You're gonna love Mardi Gras.
Felix and Oscar are at it again on The New Odd Couple. It's next on BET.